Hi, welcome to the Dynamics Tutorials. So with this problem, we have a pulley system. We have a motor over here, M, that's pulling in rope at 2 meters per second. The motor is increasing so that it's pulling in rope at an accelerated rate of 0.15 meters per second squared. And we want to find the velocity and the acceleration of this mass here that's attached to pulley B. One of the important things to do whenever you have a pulley system is try to determine how many ropes you have. So if we start here at the motor and come around with this green rope, we can see that we have one continuous rope until it's tied off here at B, and then we have a separate rope here from the tie off at B down to our mass here. So we've got different colors for these two different ropes. The next thing that we want to do is track any kind of distance that has the potential of moving. So this motor is attached to the ceiling, it's not moving. Pulley A is attached to the ceiling, it's not moving, other than rotating. But pulley B here is free to move in the Y direction. So we want to track this with a position here. We're going to use S for position and then position of B. Then we can develop an equation for the length of the green rope. So the length of the green rope is going to be three of these distances here. So we have SB here, SB here, and SB here. In addition, there's some constant material, but we're not really going to worry about that constant material because what we're going to do is take a derivative with respect to time. And so when we take the derivative of a constant with respect to time, we get zero. So we take that derivative here, so dl dt is equal to 3 times the time derivative of the position of pulley B. And now we can substitute in. We know that this rope must be decreasing because the motor is pulling it in at 2 meters per second. So the dl dt is going to be equal to negative 2 meters per second. And that's got to then be equal to that 3 times sb dot. Now the velocity at B is going to have the same magnitude as SB, but we need to see if it's changing in the same direction. So if we think about SB being fixed up here where it touches the ceiling because the ceiling's not moving, and you think about what would happen if SB was to increase. Not that SB is increasing in this problem, just a thought process to get this sign correct. So if SB is increasing, we're going to be moving down, and so that says that while ds dt is positive, the velocity of B would be negative. So the velocity of B must be equal to the negative of whatever the sb dot term is. Taking a time derivative of this, we can get that the acceleration of B must also be equal to the negative of the sb double dot. Then we can go ahead and plug this expression in here for our dl dt formula. So we had negative 2 meters per second, we had 3 times sb dot, so now we have negative 3 times vb. Solving for vb, we get vb is 0.667 meters per second. We get a positive number, so that means it's in the positive y. And then we'll go back to our dl dt and take a second derivative. So our d squared l dt squared is equal to 3 sb double dot, and then we again plug in. We know that the accelerated rate of change of this rope is 0.150 meters per second squared. That motor's getting faster, so it's also chewing up rope at an accelerated rate, so it's going to be a negative sign here in front of that value. That's got to be equal to the 3 sb double dot. Make this substitution in here, so we have that the negative 0.150 meters per second squared is equal to negative 3 acceleration of B. And then we can solve for the acceleration of B. And we get that that's 0.05 meters per second squared in the positive y direction. There's several different ways you can set up these pulley problems. This is just one of those several. You may see also solutions where a reference location is marked on the rope over here and is also tracked. And those solutions work just the same way that this one would do. If you're doing a reference mark here, typically you're going to set it up where your dl dt is equal to 0, and then you have two terms here, but it all works out the same. Thanks for watching.